Hey, what's up, y'all? It's your boy, Simply Food by TY. And look, today, y'all, I'm going to teach y'all how to make some Cajun or Creole pasta, whatever way you would like to call it. But what I'm doing right now is I'm kind of just prepping up the vegetables. Now, the good thing about this particular recipe, because we are low-key almost about to fry these vegetables, it doesn't honestly matter how beautiful they look or how big or how small you make them, because they're going to be cooking down for, you know, quite some time. So what I'm doing is I just took a half of a red onion, sliced it up normally, you know, vertically, and then I just chopped it two times in half horizontally. That's it. And I'm kind of going to treat all of these peppers pretty much kind of the same way. Now, the good thing about this type of pasta is, honestly, you can get kind of as crafty as you want, for real, for real. You can add whatever type of peppers you want. Now, depending upon, you know, how hot you really want it, you can add in some extra peppers, but then you're kind of stepping over into like more of like a Jamaican territory, you know, when you start using like Scotch bonnet peppers and, you know, stuff like that. I'm sure Creole cuisine can contain Scotch bonnet peppers, but I just feel like it changes the flavor. So just throwing that out there. None of these peppers that I'm using today are spicy at all. But as you can see, I pretty much did this yellow bell pepper the exact same way. Sliced it vertically and then chopped it three times horizontally. And as I don't know if you noticed, but I actually only used half of that yellow bell pepper. I only used half. And I'm actually going to end up doing the same thing for all of them, except for the green pepper. I think I ended up using the entire green pepper. But for the yellow and the red, I actually only ended up using about half, just because you end up not needing as many vegetables as you would think. And this actually made a very large amount of pasta. So I personally think that this was more than enough. But hey, if you are a huge vegetable lover, then by all means, you can absolutely, you know, use the entire peppers. That's completely up to you. But look, y'all, I wanted y'all to know that I have been receiving everybody's photos from all of the recipes that I have been making and that you all have been trying. And when I tell y'all, I am shook, shaketh, and done. I love them so much. So I just want to remind anybody, if any of you guys ever try out any of my recipes, please feel free. Take pictures, take videos, whatever you got to do. You can, if you want, you can email them to me at simplyfoodbyty.com. I'm sorry, simplyfoodbyty@gmail.com. Or you can go on my Instagram at simplyfoodbyty and, you know, you can send them to me on there. And eventually, I think I'm going to start doing like, you know, like probably like once a week, like a Simply Foodie appreciation post of all the people that's been trying them out because I love them. So as you guys can see, I'm going to be using some Andouille New Orleans sausage. You can use whatever type of sausage you want. But of course, the Andouille sausage will kind of keep going with the theme that we're going with here. And as you can see, I'm kind of just cutting them up into, you know, nice little slices. Nothing too fancy. You don't really need to mince those down any smaller than what you see right there. If you're able to find like the Polish kielbasa type ones, you know, the one that looks like a U, the big ones, you can use that. They didn't have any of that in stock. You know, we're in the middle of this situation in the world. So you kind of got to use what you can get. And essentially, these are the exact same thing. So that's fine. You want to chop up all four of those. I did not use the entire pack. Of course, we're going to make some penne pasta to go with this. Make sure your water is nicely salted, okay? Kosher salt. If you have the water nicely salted, you won't have to worry about seasoning your food later on as much, because you'll also have some really nicely seasoned pasta. So don't forget that. So what we're working on right now, like I said, is we're going to fry up these veggies with the sausages included. I added roughly about 3 or 4 tablespoons of olive oil, and that's it. The only seasonings that we're going to put on this is the Slap Your Mama, the hot Creole seasoning. As far as these veggies and the sausages, this is the only seasoning we're going to put, and we're actually not even going to put that much. I'm going to put roughly about 1 tablespoon worth of that seasoning on this. You don't have to add any pepper or anything like that because, like I said, this is going to be a Cajun pasta. So we're going to be making ours today with andouille sausage and with chicken. Now, as you can see, these have fried up beautifully, honey. Once those peppers and the onions turn extra soft, just like this, you know, they get a nice sear on them. Because I can't lie to you. I can't eat sausages that don't look like they've been fully cooked. So I need to see, like, some browning. Once you get that done, sit that in a bowl to the side because you're going to cook your chicken in that same pan. So, like I said, we're going to be using chicken and andouille sausage. So I actually only needed two chicken breasts for this recipe. I am trimming up some of the fat off of these at the moment. And what I'm going to do is, as you can see, I'm going to cut these in half. So I'm going to fillet these all the way down so that you end up with two pieces of the breast meat. First of all, that's going to help cook these a lot faster and it's going to let them tenderize a lot quicker as well. And then I'm just going to cut them into strips. No particular way. You know, my best advice would be just to make sure that, you know, they're somewhat consistent and even. That way you can make sure that all of your chicken is pretty much cooking around the same time and, you know, around the same speed. You don't want to have one piece of chicken that's as thick as an entire chicken breast, because then that's going to take longer, and you really want to make sure that the cooking is even. So I'm pretty much just going to do the same thing for that other chicken breast as well. Trim off the fat, and then I'm going to cut these into strips. Now, of course, you know, if you want to use this recipe and let's say you don't want to do meat, you can omit the chicken and the sausage completely, and you can do this recipe with shrimp. That's completely fine. It'd be just as delicious. Or you can do it just with vegetables. It would still be just as delicious. You know, same thing with the sausage. If you don't want to use that sausage, you absolutely do not have to. You can kind of switch it out with different things. I'm kind of just giving you the basics on how I like to make mine and the seasonings that I'm going to put in mine. So now that we got all of our chicken breast nicely prepped, we're going to take that pan, the same pan that we cooked the vegetables in, don't wash it, don't rinse it out, all that brown stuff, that's all seasoning at the bottom of that skillet. We added in roughly about another 2 or 3 tablespoons of olive oil, and now we're going to put our chicken breast in. If you want, you could also use chicken thighs. That's also another sure way of making sure that you're not going to end up with dry pieces of chicken if you're not used to working with chicken breast. So as far as the seasonings, what we're going to do is we're going to add in 1.5 tablespoons of onion powder. We're also going to be adding in roughly about, I think about 1.5 tablespoons of garlic powder as well. This is one of those type of things, you guys, where you don't need no measuring. You do not need measuring utensils. You really don't. It's kind of one of those things where you look at the food, you put the seasoning on it. You know what I mean? Like, everything doesn't always require you to have, measuring utensils. Right now, I'm putting on black pepper, but that was roughly about 1 teaspoon's worth of black pepper. If you are a black pepper lover, feel free to add more. Now, this right here is the smoked paprika. Be careful with that. Don't add too much. If I were you, I would do 1/2 teaspoon, okay? Use about 1/2 teaspoon. If you can measure it, measure it. Because you don't want to go too far, because smoked paprika is pretty, pretty potent. And now, of course, we're going to be adding on the rest of our Creole, the Creole seasoning, the Slap Your Mama Hot. And that's it as far as the seasonings, you guys. When I tell you, I was actually so surprised. You know, like, typically, you know, when you get to the end of your dish and you start doing the taste testing, you find yourself that you need to add, you know, like, maybe a little bit of salt, pepper. Baby, I didn't have to add a single thing to this dish by the time this was done. It literally turned out perfect, and I was shook. Don't worry, you will be as well. So now that we got our chicken really, really starting to brown off, which is exactly what we want, the next thing we're going to do now is we're going to go ahead and add back in the sausage, the peppers, and the onions. See, to me, I like to cook it all separately just so that every aspect of it will do exactly what I want. Meaning those sausages will properly brown, those veggies will get nice and soft. And so now we're mixing all of that seasoning all together before we start to add in the penne pasta. Now, what I like to do is I like to add the penne pasta in little by little. I did not end up using that full box. If anything, if you don't want to be wasting noodles, only cook about 1/2 of the box, because I definitely didn't need as many noodles as I cooked. Now, what I'm doing is I'm also adding in another layer of flavoring, because instead of just going right into making the sauce, what you want to do is toss those noodles around in all of that seasoning that's coating on the chicken, the sausage, the peppers, on the noodles. So that way some of that seasoning can really adhere to the noodles. I'm telling you, these steps might seem like a foolish mistake, but I promise you, these are the type of steps that can really elevate your dish and make it something completely different. Now for the sauce, I'm gonna be using some heavy whipping cream. Now I didn't measure this, but what I will tell you is that I used roughly about a half a cup to 1 cup. The best thing about this is you can't really go wrong with the heavy whipping cream, in all honesty. It's just honestly a matter of how much sauce would you like. I'm going to be adding in a half a cup of Parmesan cheese. So you really can't mess up when it comes to the sauce. It's just honestly a matter of, once again, of how much sauce would you like. So I added in, like I said, roughly about, I would say about 1 cup's worth of the heavy whipping cream. Once you add that cheese to it, keep your temperature, I would say, roughly on about a medium high, just until you start to see it slightly start to bubble. And then once it does that, go on ahead and reduce the temperature, because you don't want the heavy whipping cream to burn to the bottom of your skillet. As that heavy whipping cream really starts to warm up, and as the cheese melts, it's going to start to thicken, and it's going to turn into a delicious, delicious sauce. You know me, I like to add a little bit of parsley on everything just for the sake of color. But yeah, so what I was saying was, is just really make sure, though, that you are keeping an eye, because as you can see already in the bottom of that skillet, that sauce is already thickening up. This isn't something, in my opinion, that you want like drenched in sauce where you feel like you need a spoon and all of that type of stuff. It's honestly just enough to coat the noodles. These noodles are not dry, this dish is not dry. And the good thing is, if you're worried about making too much sauce, add the heavy whipping cream in little by little. But look, you guys, that was it. Look, if you are new to my channel, welcome to Simply Food by TY. If you're one of my returning subscribers, y'all babies know I love y'all so much. I hope y'all try out this recipe, because I'm telling you, it is everything. All right, y'all babies, stay cute and take care. Bye.
Slaying in the kitchen.
Simply Food by TY.
We hope that you enjoyed
Simply
it.
Simply Food by TY. If you haven't took the time, make sure you subscribe. Thanks for watching. Thanks for watching. Thanks for watching Simply Food by TY.